This is Jarrod Horak for the RunawayHorse.com, and welcome back for my second video this week. In that last video, I just recapped the Kentucky Derby. Medina Spirit was obviously the winner in that race for trainer Bob Baffert. Baffert winning his seventh Kentucky Derby, John Velazquez with his fourth Derby winner. Also, he went wire to wire in that race, and now can he win the Preakness Stakes and give a and win the first two legs of the Triple Crown and then have a shot at winning the Triple Crown? We're going to find that out at Pimlico next week. Now, before I get to all that, as I mentioned in my last video, we had our most viewed video ever on our channel last week. Our top five most likely Kentucky Derby winners netted over 45,000 views. So thank you very much for watching, for subscribing to the channel, for making comments. It's just been an excellent Kentucky Derby for us on the number of views on the videos that we've done. We also did the three live long shots that got, I think, over 7,000 views. So thanks very much for watching all these Triple Crown videos. And we're going to continue to cover these three-year-olds even beyond the Triple Crown. We're going to be covering them for the Haskell, the Travers, and races like that. But now this is the Preakness preview. And if you're interested in my full card for Preakness Day, I had record sales for my Kentucky Derby full card. Had a very good day, over $2,400 in winning tickets, four top choice winners, two best bet winners on that card. We had the pick three ending with the Kentucky Derby. We had an earlier pick four, just missed with one of my best bets, Dream Shake. That would have netted me another best bet winner, trifecta pick four and pick five in the Kentucky Derby. All around it for our wagering strategies, just weren't able to quite get the job done. Those top four finishers separated by a little more than a length. Any of the four horses could have ended up winning the Kentucky Derby, but nobody could get past Medina Spirit in there. And we just couldn't get Hot Rod Charlie or Essential Quality, my top two, to finish first or second. If one of those two would have run one or two, definitely would have cashed some tickets in the Kentucky Derby. But not disappointed there. All you can hope for in a race like the Kentucky Derby is you handicap the race, your horses get decent trips, and you have a shot turning for home. And that's exactly what happened. All of our top contenders were in contention. They ran well, and it just didn't quite go my way. But that happens in racing. And hopefully in the Preakness Stakes, we can bounce back and get some winning tickets. And now we're going to preview that Preakness Stakes, and it's going to be at Pimlico Race Course in Baltimore on Saturday, May 15th, 2021. And in that Preakness Stakes, right now there are nine horses pointing to the Preakness Stakes. And Medina Spirit, obviously your Kentucky Derby winner for Bob Baffert, probably going to be forwardly placed, and he should make his presence felt throughout. He's not a horse that has to have the lead, but he should be up close to the pace. Maybe his stablemate, Concert Tour, the horse that could have run in the Kentucky Derby, he had the points, but trainer Bob Baffert decided not to run. He was disappointed in his effort in the Arkansas Derby, where he battled on the pace with the Caddo River, but he was not able to get clear. And as the heavy favorite in that race, he ended up finishing third. He just battled with Caddo River, and they were really in the battle for second because Superstock won that one pretty easily, and Concert Tour ended up finishing third. But he looked good winning his other three races, the San Vicente Stakes and the Rebel Stakes, where he got out there and controlled the pace. So looking at it, with Baffert having the two main speed horses in the race, you would have to think Concert Tour seems like a need-to-lead type after he wired the field in the Rebel Stakes, and then he didn't get the lead and he didn't run as well in the Arkansas Derby. So you got to think that they want to put him on the lead, whereas Medina Spirit is one that's more versatile. And the two stablemates, I don't see them dueling on the lead. I see maybe Concert Tour setting the pace, Medina Spirit tracking him, and possibly John Velazquez is going to hope that maybe Concert Tour just can't go a mile and 3/16, and he already knows that Medina Spirit has a fighting spirit, and he's already won a grade one race at a mile and a quarter, the Kentucky Derby. So Medina Spirit should make his presence felt throughout, and Concert Tour should as well. The next horse that's ran in the Kentucky Derby that's going to run in the Preakness Stakes is Midnight Bourbon for trainer Steve Asmussen. I think he's very dangerous in a race like the Preakness Stakes, a little bit shorter than the Derby. He's one that has experience in these longer races. At the Preakness distance in the Louisiana Derby, he was second to Hot Rod Charlie. And then Hot Rod Charlie came back and ran a good third in the Kentucky Derby. Mandaloon also ran in that Louisiana Derby, and he didn't hit the board. But he ran well in the other races in Louisiana on the road to the Derby this year, and he ended up finishing second in the Kentucky Derby. And then Obesos was another one that ran in that race, and he was fifth in the Derby. So as you see, overall, the Louisiana form from the LeCompte Stakes, from the Risen Star Stakes, from the Louisiana Derby, has been holding up well. Their speed figures were solid in those races, and the horses were quality horses. And Midnight Bourbon's one that has early pressing speed, and look for him to be in the hunt throughout. He could easily bounce back after finishing sixth in the Derby when he didn't get involved early with a bit of a troubled start. A shorter field in the Preakness Stakes, a little bit of a shorter distance. If he can get up there and at least track the leaders, he could be very dangerous, and he could be the upsetter, maybe the most likely upsetter in the Preakness Stakes. Crowded Trade for trainer Chad Brown looks a lot like his winner of the Preakness from Preakness Past, Cloud Computing. Cloud Computing came into the Preakness, and he only had three career starts, winning his debut, hitting the board in the Gotham, and then the Wood Memorial. They decided to skip the Derby, point to the Preakness, and Cloud Computing was able to win the Preakness that year. And then Crowded Trade has the same exact record. He won his debut, he hit the board in the Gotham, he hit the board in the Wood Memorial, and now Chad Brown's going to try to do the same thing. He could have run in the Derby, he skipped it, and now they're pointing to the Preakness. They've been pointing to the Preakness. The main problem is Chad Brown's just not quite sure how far Crowded Trade wants to run. He thought Cloud Computing was one that could excel over longer distances. He's just not sure about Crowded Trade, but he's lightly raced. He's dangerous in here for Chad Brown to at least finish somewhere in the top three. Rombauer, he qualified in a win and you're in for the Preakness in the El Camino Real Derby at Golden Gate Fields on all weather ground over the winter. And then he was third in the Bluegrass Stakes last time out, behind Highly Motivated and Essential Quality. Those two controlled the pace. Rombauer likes to close, and he didn't get much pace help, and he was best of the rest in third. So Rombauer's one that if he can get enough pace, he can at least finish somewhere in the trifecta in the Preakness Stakes. Keep Me in Mind, he rallied from 19th and last to finish 7th in the Derby, and he's probably going to be last early in the Preakness Stakes, and he's going to be trying to pass tired horses, and he needs pace help, and I don't know that he's going to get enough pace help in the Preakness Stakes, but he will be trying to finish at the end. We have a horse from Japan, France Go De Inna. This one, real mystery. We don't know what I have no idea how he's going to run in the Preakness Stakes. So this is your long shot mystery horse from overseas, and we'll see how he does in the Preakness. Unbridled Honor, a late runner for trainer Todd Pletcher. Now, last time out in the Lexington Stakes, he rallied. The pace was very fast. It was an electric pace that day. It was a wet track, and he rallied to hit the board in that race. I don't think he's going to get an electric pace in the Preakness. I'm not sure about the track condition, but we know if it is wet that he handles a wet track, and he does have a decent late kick. And then finally, a Ram for trainer Dwayne Lucas. Back-to-back wins versus Lesser. He won on the Kentucky Derby undercard. He pulled off an upset. So he's sharp. He's improving, but he's going to really have to improve if he's going to beat horses like Medina Spirit, Concert Tour, Midnight Bourbon, and the other top contenders in the Preakness Stakes. Now, one of the things you want to look for in the Preakness is obviously the new shooters, horses that did not run in the Kentucky Derby. Now, typically, at least in recent history, if you look at the Preakness results, horses that ran in the Derby and didn't win the Derby won the bulk of the Preakness Stakes. But we had plenty of horses that won the Derby also win the Preakness. And then the other angle is horses that did not run in the Kentucky Derby and then they run in the Preakness Stakes. They don't win very often, even though it did happen last year with Swiss Skydiver. Typically, the horses that did not run in the Preakness in the Kentucky Derby and then they end up running in the Preakness, they do hit the board fairly often. Since 2014, at least one horse that did not run in the Kentucky Derby finished in the trifecta in the Preakness Stakes. And I think in four of those years, from 2014 to 2020, four times you had two horses, two trifecta finishers, hit the board in the Preakness Stakes. So you had horses that did not run in the Derby fill out two of those slots in the trifectas four times since 2014. So horses that didn't run in the Derby can certainly hit the board in the Preakness. So I think the most likely scenario is somebody that ran in the Derby is going to win the Preakness, and then maybe one or two horses that didn't run in the Derby could hit the board in the Preakness Stakes. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. Who do you like? Who's your early selection in the Preakness Stakes? Again, if you're interested in my Preakness Day full card, it will be available at therunawayhorse.com Preakness Week. And that full card, again, Preakness Week, next week at therunawayhorse.com. And that will wrap up this video. I'll be back next week. Next week is my Preakness video, where I'm going to go through all the contenders and then give out my top selection. Until then, good luck at the races.